Hi, and thank you for joining me today. This is your friendly neighborhood librarian, and today we're going to be going over a database called SpringerLink. To find this database, you're going to need to start off at the library website, and you can get there by going to library.pnw.edu, or if you're on any PNW page, you're going to find a link to the library at the top. On the page, you're going to want to scroll down and look for the Find section, and then click on Databases. After you click on Databases, you can go ahead and use this search box to search for Springer. It's going to come up with any database that has Springer in the title or description. We only have one. Go ahead and click on the database. If you're off campus, it's going to ask you to enter in your PNW username and password before it will give you access. If you're on campus, you should go straight to a window that looks like this. At this database, we're going to go ahead and search those keywords that we've been using so far. Lightweight, regolith, excavation. Okay, and using those keywords, I've gotten 40 results. You're going to notice this section right here that says include preview only content. I would uncheck that. Preview only content, you're not going to have full text access to. But in this case, we still have 40 results. So everything that's showing up, we do have access to. And if you just look under content type, you're going to see 34 chapters, 5 articles, a conference paper, and a reference work entry. Springer provides you with a lot of different resource types, including books and articles and conferences. If you go ahead and scroll down, you can look at the titles of the different results that are coming up, and you can also see what kind of resource this is. If you wanted to, you could actually decide that you only want to see things that fall under the engineering discipline. We're now cut down to only 18 results. However, when you do use those discipline and then sub-discipline limiters, it's going to provide you with more relevant results than what you were seeing before. Occasionally, it will get rid of a resource that could be useful, so if you're only getting a few results, I would go through those titles before using the limiters. And going through, I do see Resource Prospector, a cost-effective lunar resource pathfinder. I might check this out given I am more focused on creating an extraterrestrial robot, or maybe I'll look at Mars ISRU technology and see what that's about. Sometimes titles are going to be very short and not give you much information, whereas other times they're going to be long and give you a really good idea of what a chapter or an article could be about. If you go ahead and click on that, we then see the title of this chapter is still at the top, and now we also have the title of the book, and it's telling us the pages that we're looking at. There is a Cite As button as well, here and here, to assist you with getting that Works Cited page ready. You can download a PDF of this chapter or the entire book using this link here. And if you scroll down, you can read the abstract to try and get an idea of what you're going to find here, and we're seeing those keywords again. Make sure you pay attention to these and take note if you do find a resource that is really useful. Okay, and let's go ahead and click download to read the full chapter text. Depending on your browser settings, it may open a new tab, new window, or just completely download for you. And you would want to make sure that you save this either to your hard drive, a flash drive, or email it to yourself. Let's go back to Springer now. Okay, and we're gonna go ahead and change up our results. I'm not entirely sure that what I found is what I need. I'm gonna remove that lightweight, like we've done in other videos, and see if I get more results. Okay, after doing that, I'm starting off with 64 results. These 64 results still have that engineering discipline limiter set to them. So I'm feeling even better about this because now that means I'm getting 64 instead of the 18 we had when we initially used that limiter. If you look at the subdisciplines, we have aerospace technology and astronautics, planetology, extraterrestrial physics and space sciences. These all feel like each of them may be getting closer to what I was looking for. But this very first result, lunar drilling, excavation, and mining in support of science exploration, construction, and in situ resource utilization, feels like it would be useful to me just looking at that title. However, I would like to check out what articles we have here. So I'm going to click on article to cut out some of those book chapters. I want some shorter information. Okay, and I kind of like this title, Inhabiting the Solar System, so I'm going to take a look at this. Alright, and we have the title of our article, when it was published, the journal it was published in, our author, We still have those cite options. We now have a share article option that you could use to share this with someone else. And we also have that download PDF option still. If you go down, you can read the abstract, get that short summary. And we have quite a few different keywords that we could then try using in our search if we wanted to change things up. If you scroll further down, you're going to see that download to read the full article text. And we also have our references. So if you click download, it's going to go ahead and open again, and you're going to notice that this looks distinctly different from the chapter we were looking at earlier. This has been a short overview of our SpringerLink resource, which can be very useful in both engineering and technology fields. If you have any questions, please contact the library, and good luck!